I want you to look at your neighbor on your right and say, neighbor, it is given to you to know the mysteries of the kingdom of God. Tell them again and say, to know, not to imagine, the mysteries of the kingdom of God. Because people think that, you know, God is this liberal guy who is making sure everything has got someone, everything, you know, everybody has got something. No, no, no. Here in the scripture, the parable is saying, this is Christ even who is sharing. And whoever has, to him shall be given. And whoever is more in to it, and he shall have more abundance. But whosoever have not, from him shall be taken even what he had. I wanted to turn to your neighbor, to your right or to your left, and tell them, if you have nothing, everything will be taken away from you. Even what you think you have. If you are broke, brother, in the spirit, you are going to be broken than what you are. Now, when we begin to speak about the kingdom of God, many people now understand the kingdom. And what we've been told during the conference was that, you know, God is amazing in that he uses the Bible, the same Bible, he's been using the same Bible to change different generations. He began with the Moseses and the Abrahams, they were reading the same Bible. But the thing that he was doing with them from generation to generation are different. And now we are living in a very different generation. And we want to know that during this time, during this dispensation where we are living, there is more of what the kingdom of God is that has been revealed than what was revealed back then. In other words, what Paul knew about the kingdom of God, we must know more because we are living in a different generation. It is during this time that we must be able to explain God more than the apostles could explain God. We must be able to explain Christ more than the apostles were able to explain Christ. I wanted to tell your neighbor, I said, you must know the mysteries of the kingdom of God. Don't be afraid of them. Tell them and say, you must know the secrets, the mysteries, the hidden things of the kingdom of God. The problem that we have is that we are in a kingdom, we don't know the secrets of the kingdom. You know, when you are a visitor and you get into my house, I will sit you down maybe in the lounge where there is the television, probably a few sofas. You will not know anything else that is in my house because at the end of your visit, if during your visit, I'll bring you water if you say you want water. I'll bring you food if you say you want food. And when you're about to go, I'll not say to you, let me show you my house. I'll say, okay. And I'll open the same door which you used to come in, and I'll lead you to the same gate which you used to go and come in. You don't want to be like that in the kingdom of God, whereby you only know the sitting area of the kingdom of God. You only know the sitting area which is called the church. Tell your neighbor and say, neighbor, it is not enough for you just to know the sitting room of the kingdom of God. You must begin to understand and to seek to know what else is available in the place where we are sitting. You must be able to ask yourself and say, what more do I know of what is here? In the morning I gave an example and I said, you know, what color of shirt am I wearing? Let me try it here. We say, what color of shirt am I wearing?
White.
The white shirt. What kind of color of shirt am I wearing?
White.
Now, I will send you to go to Guinea and then begin to explain what color of shirt, what am I going to tell them?
It's white.
But the day that I remove my jacket, you people are going to say you are lying. Because behind here, the shirt is black. It's only this part and this which are white. But because you are explaining according to what has been revealed, you are explaining, but you are not explaining enough. Because you yourself don't know it. So people are trying to explain and to worship a Christ whom they did not know, but they just seen a portion of, and they try to go around worshiping him. I want you to know, this is the year of heaven, and if we are going to have, we must have the ability to explain and to know the fullness of the kingdom of God. It is not enough just to know the systems of church. It is not enough just to know the names of the pastors. It is not enough just to come here and know the name of the church. But you have to know something that is beyond the sitting room. Tell your neighbor,